I think we're in a race against time before we flood the oceans and the landscape with waste plastic, but also before we fill the atmosphere with carbon dioxide. So we need to move as quickly as possible to develop technologies that we can implement on a large scale. My name is Paul Dauenhauer, and I'm a chemical engineer. Renewable resources like grasses and trees are incredibly low cost, and there's no reason we can't manufacture all the materials we use today using the trees, grasses, and agricultural products around us. The challenge of manufacturing sustainable materials is we're competing with fossil fuel technologies that have been around for a century, and the technologies to manufacture materials from petroleum and natural gas are incredibly efficient, which is why they're low cost. So if we're going to manufacture new materials from biomass that are sustainable, they have to be as good as the current fossil fuel derived materials. But also they need to have additional functionality. So we need to build into them things like biodegradability or recyclability. And finally, they have to be cost competitive with fossil fuel derived materials. One of the projects that we work on is to take biomass and convert it into the feedstocks and chemicals that we use to make renewable materials like renewable rubber. In this case, we make a molecule called isoprene. Isoprene is the key chemical that's used in manufacturing car tires, and if we can make it from biomass, your car tire can be exactly the same as you get from fossil fuel derived materials, but instead it's made from trees, grasses, and plants. Society thinks of energy and fuels the same way we think about plastics and polymers. When we're done with them, we throw them away. In the case of fuels, we throw away the carbon dioxide into the atmosphere as waste. So what we'd like to do, just like we can recycle polymers, is we'd like to create a fuel that's either carbon-free or made from the CO2 in the atmosphere, so we have a closed cycle. So the challenge with converting renewable electricity into carbon-free fuels has to do with the design of the chemical technology. In this case, we can't make catalysts that are fast enough to shrink down in size to put to places like windmills or solar panels. The challenge with making chemical reactions go faster with catalysts is that essentially a catalyst needs to do a lot of things at once. The chemical reaction has many parts, and the catalyst has to fit each of those parts at the same time. So we've taken an approach to thinking about chemistry the way we think about music. Every part of the chemistry has a frequency, just like sound. And if we find the right sounds or the right frequencies of music, we can actually resonate those frequencies and speed them up thousands of times. This lets us make smaller, faster reactors that we can use in places where we need to generate carbon-free fuels from renewable solar or wind power. The benefit of these carbon-free fuels made from renewable power is that they can be stored indefinitely. We can keep them and use them when we need them. And when we use them, we only emit things like air or water, which are already in the atmosphere. So I think we could build an entirely new infrastructure of renewable materials that are both sustainable, but also drive local economies.